order on the regular meeting of the common council, Monday, August 27th, 2012 at 9 a.m. Roll call, please. Could we have a local minister come forward, please? And after the invocation, then I'll ask Mark Orshon to do the pledge of allegiance.
Let's pray. Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for the opportunity of coming together. Lord, I ask you to give the wisdom of Solomon for our town council that they would make the decisions that they need to make. Lord, we give you all the glory for it. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
First, I want to discuss the storm damage. As most of you know, last week,
the northwest quadrant of the town experienced considerable storm damage due to flooding. Moon Mountain and Saguaro Roads experienced severe undercutting, and about 500 feet of Saguaro Road was washed away. The heavy flooding on Moon Mountain caused the concrete casing of the water main to move enough to cause a break in the water main. Pressure dropped substantially as the Copa well continued to pump and to keep the pressure up. Water maintenance worker Jeff Sorensen located the break and shut off the water on each side of it at about 1 a.m. that morning. We were fortunate that the break occurred where there was no service to property, so no one was without water. Unfortunately, the pump at the Copa well was exposed, which caused the pump to burn up. We always have a second pump to switch to in the event of such an emergency, but now we are looking at having to replace that pump and rebuild two portions of two roads. Additionally, more than one manhole and or vent was infiltrated by and the treatment plant was experiencing excessive storm water. Rob Troxler and his crew worked all night to prevent an overflow, and they were successful. We have contacted Southwest Risk and sent the pictures of the damage, and they will be able to recover some of the cost of repairs through our insurance. Also last week, regarding the wastewater treatment plant expansion, at long last, we have received funding from USDA for the expansion of the treatment plant. This is a grant loan package that includes approximately $2.9 million in grant funds. By splitting a loan portion of the grant match between WIFA and USDA funding, the two types of funding, we were able to expedite this project. The project will come before council as soon as the documents are prepared. Lastly, there's been quite a bit of conversation lately regarding administrative leave. All the council has received a memorandum from the town attorney. A lot of questions have come up since the town's press release stating that Sergeant Garcia, Police Chief Gilbert, were placed on paid administrative leave. Everyone, particularly the council, wants the details of why and how come. This is absolutely understandable. It is therefore important to know that pursuant to the chief's contract, any appeal that he may have regarding the outcome of an investigation must go before council and not the personnel board. It is imperative, therefore, that the council remain neutral so they can reach a decision that is fair. Council's curiosity may taint the chief's ability to appeal if necessary. Sergeant Garcia, as a classified employee, would be able to present appeal to the personnel board should she desire as part of her due process. I have contacted police departments of Lake Havasu City and Yuma to see if they are willing to investigate this matter. I should hear today. Apopka County Sheriff's Department has declined due to the many interactions they have with Chief Gilbert as part of regular police work. In the memorandum that you received from our town attorney, he further clarifies some of these issues. Okay, consent agenda.
I move we approve the consent agenda with the changes made by Council Member Wertzel. Second.
Okay, we've had a motion and a second. Any discussion?
I'm going to ask about these checks. Do you
have a question? That would go to the resolution.
Okay. Okay, being no discussion, we'll go to the vote. Those that approve?
Aye.
Aye. Not approve?
Okay, so instead of starting a new business item one, we'll start with the checks.
Now, okay. Check 242.42 for an excise tax revenue bond obligation for $26,383.34. Who signed this check and what is this for?
This check is part of our bond obligation that we've had for quite some time with regard to water and sewer expansion. I believe we've had this in place since before 2006. So it was a council action back then that authorized this to go forward.
3 for capital lease principal for $1,043. What are we leasing?
Usually that's a vehicle. I can, let's see, 130. I can give that to you if you like, but I don't have it off the top. Is Tim here? Do you remember what it was?
What's the amount?
$1,043
that's
to Wells Fargo.
That's our copier.
Okay.
We have a leasing agreement for our copier.
Is it an annual?
Yeah, no, yeah. It's monthly.
Okay.
Or quarterly.
Are you saying that we actually pay $1,043 per month?
I correct myself, it's quarterly.
No.
We got check 34246 for on-call engineering service for $2,040.07. What is this for?
On-call engineering service is part of the contract that we signed with Atkins Engineering. It used to be PBS&J. And we use that for plan check. And recently, the most recent plan check we did was Shea Oil. And that's what it's for. Okay.
Now we got check 34263 for legal services for $5,528. What is that for? At which point is being represented by Barry and Branch?
That's a tax issue. And again, that's gone before council several times. It's an ongoing project and it will be included in my legal report. But that Barry Branch is handling exclusively one tax issue.
Check 34267, Investigative Resource Services for $1,695.50, $253.50. Is this the final payment? Because it's my understanding that the report of the voters was already completed. And I want to know why a copy of it isn't in the library because it was paid for with public money.
It's still a attorney work product. It is not redacted. It still has to go to the election attorney in Phoenix, which is Gamage and Burnham. They need to review it, and that is why it is not available in the library.
Do you know how much longer that's going to be?
We're guessing the end of September at the latest.
Okay, check 34271 for Southwest Risk legal fees for $13,377.76. Is this, which lawsuit is this for?
Mr. Orgeron.
Okay. Check 34292 for more on-call engineering services for $1,656.34. What was this bill for?
Water Master Plan is part of it, and then a 1600. There were several plan checks they had to do with Shea. One was, of course, the structural, Cryo was a separate structural engineer, and the other is civil. We do some of it, they do some of it, depending on how technical it is.
Mrs. Workman, anytime you see the name Atkins there, that's our town engineer. So if you see Atkins, that's the contract we have for town engineering. So if you see that in the future, that's anything that says Atkins is that.
All right, Darren, new business item 2.
I move that we table item 2, approval of the resolution for the budget, until after our special meeting is held.
Second.
If the council does not approve the budget today, this is the last day to approve the budget.
Yes, sir. We're well aware of that, and we know that by not approving the budget today, we can operate on last year's budget.
As long as you're aware that you're missing the deadline.
Yes, we're well aware of that.
As a point of clarification,
motion, you're asking to adjourn the item on table, right? You're not going to bring it back up in this meeting?
I am not going to bring it back up.
If you, tabling means moving to later in the same meeting, if you're going to move it to another meeting, you adjourn. So your motion would be to adjourn the item rather than...
Until the next regular meeting, or until after our special meeting.
Right, so just move to adjourn rather than...
Okay, thank you. For item number two, I move that we adjourn the item to the next regular meeting or until after the council special meeting is held.
Second. All right, we have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Being none, we'll go to the vote. Those that approve?
Aye.
Not approve?
Nay.
Okay, item number three.
I move that item number three be adjourned until the next regular meeting or until such time as we have held our special meeting.
Second. All right, there's been a motion and a second. Any discussion?
Yeah, I keep hearing a reference to a special meeting. What special meeting are we talking about?
Three of the council members have requested a special meeting to be held on Saturday. We believe that it was delayed so that it was not feasible time-wise in which to hold this meeting.
You talked about a previous special meeting.
Correct. Again, this morning, I turned in another request signed by three council members to hold a special meeting tomorrow at 3 p.m.
Tomorrow, Wednesday?
Oh,
3 p.m. tomorrow?
Yes, sir.
There are some of us who are supposed to be in Scottsdale about that night.
I understand that.
And we're going there at town expense, so...
I'm well aware of that.
Telephonic.
Any more discussion? Being none, we'll go to the vote. Those in favor?
Aye.
Not?
Nay.
Item number four.
For item number four, I move that... When we move the check for Ms. Portman to new business that became... Okay, we're on item four.
Yes.
Thank you. I move that we adjourn item four to the next regular meeting or until such time we have had the capability to have a special meeting.
Second. Okay, we've had a motion and a second. Any discussion?
Why can't we handle this today? Is there a valid reason we need to adjourn them to a future meeting?
Yes, sir, because I feel that we are being blocked by town administration from having a special meeting that must be held. And until such time, this is our only recourse to have our special meeting.
Okay, any more discussion? Being none, we'll move to the vote. Those that approve?
Aye.
Aye.
Nay.
Item number five.
For item number five, I move that we adjourn this to the next regular meeting or until such time as we were able to have a special meeting.
Second. Okay, we have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Being none, we'll go to the vote. Those that approve?
Aye.
Aye.
Nay. Item number six.
I move that item number six be adjourned to the next regular meeting or until such time as we are able to have a special meeting.
Second. Okay, we have a motion and a second. Any discussion? Being none, we'll move to the vote. Those in favor?
Aye.
Nay.